यस सर।
स्लाइड स्लाइड दिख रहा है ना?
यस सर।
हाँ ठीक। देयर आर सम मोर रिएक्शंस रिगार्डिंग द फॉर्मेशन एंड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द फ्री रेडिकल्स। देयर आर सो मेनी मेथड्स। जैसे मैं ये कुछ मेरा अपने हैंड रिटन मटेरियल्स है। सो जस्ट लाइक फ्री रेडिकल रिएक्शन, ब्रोमीन ब्रोमीन ऑन द ऑन फोटो रिएक्शन गिव्स फ्री रेडिकल, देन इट क्रिएट्स विद एल्केन और एल्किल हैलाइड, टू गिव यू द एल्किल फ्री रेडिकल एंड टू फ्री रेडिकल्स कंबाइंड टुगेदर। दिस इज अ चेन टर्मिनेशन प्रोसेस फ्रॉम ब्रोमीन मॉलिक्यूल लाइक दैट। Association inhibited by the addition of inhibitors or radical scavengers like phenol, quinones, diphenylamines, iodines, etc. Triphenyl methyl free radical, this was the first free radical that was detected, and it has been obtained from the reaction with triphenyl methyl chloride with silver to form the trimethylfluorine free radicals. So these are the reactions of the free radicals. The free radicals, once formed, it reacts with halogens to form triphenyl methyl halide plus X free radical, and it will again react with the phenyl free radical to form the final product. Similarly, if you have triphenyl methyl free radical reaction with oxygen or in the presence of air, it gives you the acyl free radical that combines with the next molecule of triphenyl methyl free radical to give you the peroxide, like this term. Similarly, tetramethyl lead is type can also be free radical, can or triphenyl methyl free radical type radicals are really more stable than alkyl radicals. Tetramethyl lead can also be undergo this kind of reaction to form the methyl type of free radical that combines together to form a alkane molecule. From preparation again, it is from the amines, secondary amine on reaction in the presence of manganese metal type KMN4 like system, potassium permanganate type of thing. Then it undergo to form tetraaryl hydrazine that dissociates to form the diphenyl amine free radical. ठीक है ना? These are these shows green color in the medium. These are the hetero atom containing radicals. Right? Someone drawing something. ठीक है? Slides दिख रहा है ना? वो आप लोगों में से अगर problem हो slide नहीं दिख रहा है तो immediately कोई ना कोई बोल दीजिएगा. ठीक है? Similarly, phenyl hydrazine in presence of pipyl chloride, it generates pipyl chlorides to form 2,4,6 trinitrophenyl hydrazine. Then in the presence of lead oxide, it also generates free radicals 1,1-diphenyl-2-pipyl hydroxyl. It is usually unreactive with neutral molecules but can react with other radicals. It is used as a trap molecule to form a stable product. So this hydrazine free radicals, then this is a radical that can be trapped with this molecule to isolate this kind of radical intermediate. So with the help of trapping method, you can isolate the radicals that has been found during the course of reaction. One of the stable radical is oxygen containing radical, phenoxy radical. This one, this phenoxide and ion, this is phenoxide ion when it reacts with K3 Fe ferric ferrocyanide, then it generates the this kind of more stable phenoxy free radical. Due to bulky alkyl tertiary butyl group, they are unreactive because of the hindrance, but they are very very stable. By the photolysis, अभी photochemistry हम लोग पढ़ेंगे ही पढ़ेंगे. तो keto compounds on photo irradiation gives free radicals, methyl free radicals, acyl free radical. They may combine together to form the products. Hypochlorites on photo irradiation can gives you the alkoxy free radical, CF free radical. Nitrides can also give you the alkoxy radical, nitroso alkyls. So these are the some properties or the advantages of the photochemical reactions. Similarly, the cleavage of diacyl peroxides, of those semester one padenge on photo irradiation gives you peroxy free radicals, then alkyl free radicals. Flash photolysis, this is a technique that provides using intense pulse of the radiation to generate the by visible light or UV light, it will is going to give you the free radicals. By the thermolysis, like tetra alkyl lead on thermolysis also going to generate the alkyl free radicals. By this method only weak bonds can be cleaved. Okay, weak bond can be cleaved that has energy of around 165 kilojoule per mole. Such bonds very often involve elements rather than the carbon, like peroxide, OO bond, azo bond. Okay, na? Sometimes this strong condition is required to stabilize the product radical. However, the substituents having more stabilizing capability are required to produce radicals. कोई ज्वाइन कर रहा है ठीक है ना, स्लाइड इज विजिबल?
यस सर।
हाँ ठीक है, मैं बार बार चेक कर रहा हूँ कि उसका ऑफ ना हो जाए, नहीं तो स्लाइड दिखता नहीं। जैसे उस दिन मैं क्लास पढ़ा रहा था वो स्लाइड ऑफ हो गया। सिंपल एल्किल एजो alkyl azo too stable to undergo thermolysis but can be made useful by the introduction of the suitable substituents like AIBN, as I told you, to form this kind of free radical, azo free radical. Then by redox reaction in the presence of copper. Actually, all these things I have taught in the last lecture, but this is for my own way I have written this study material. Auto oxidation, low temperature oxidation of organic compound by oxygen. It may be initiated by some free trace metals like copper or by light or by any radical initiators to form the free radicals. Okay, na? Radicals, then this alkane type of system that it is going to generate a. This is the initiator radical, initiator to form a free radical. Then it reacts with oxygen to form peroxide. Then it is reacts with the another molecule of alkane to form the hydroperoxide. Sometimes it breaks also. If this molecule itself breaks from here to form the alkoxy radicals as well as hydroxy radical. This is called the now it is initiated again. That is why it is called the auto oxidation process. फिर alkoxy radical generate हो गया, फिर से reaction करने लगेगा। Similarly, the NBS N-bromosuccinimide is highly selective in only attacking weak CH bond, allylic and benzylic. It requires a radical initiator to affect bromination through a low ambient concentration of the bromine. This maintained through reaction of HBr. Produce in reaction with NBS, there is usually a trace of bromine or HBr in NBS that can react with the substrate molecule to generate the initiator Br free radical to start the reaction. So, you know, for example, Br2 or HBr plus initiator going to give you the Br free radical. Now this Br free radical then reacts with the, suppose you have an cycloalkene system, cyclohexene. Then it is supposed to have a allylic system here, ring 1, 2, 3 carbon system that is going to form a allylic free radical plus HBr. Then it is again going to react with the bromine molecule to form the bromocyclohexene plus Br free radical that can again combine together in the chain termination process to form the bromine molecule. So overall reaction is that cyclohexene, which has internal allylic system, which reacts with Br free radicals to form this kind of product that can be further with the H molecule, hydrogen molecule from this, it will take hydrogen from the system to form the final product. Another example of the auto oxidation, the peroxy radicals are usually of low reactivity and are highly selective to abstract hydrogen. Thus, the allylic and benzylic sites are relatively readily attacked because such CH bonds are slightly weak and the resultant radical, RM is radical, get stabilized due to the delocalization. Similarly, this kind of again system, cyclopentene, this on the peroxy free radical changes to form the peroxy derivative, cyclopentene peroxy derivative. This is the tetrahydronaphthalene or tetraline. This on reaction with hydrogen peroxide converts into the peroxide derivative. This peroxide derivative itself in the presence of base converts into the alpha tetralone. This one, the alpha tetralone, or on reduction, it converts into the alpha tetrol. That is the hydroxy derivative. This one is the hydroxy derivative, while this one is the keto derivative. So this is the example of the auto oxidation. I think someone has joined. Now, auto oxidation, like pentones reaction, we have discussed kiya tha. This is the another example in which the auto oxidation of aldehyde to acid. Fe3 plus in the presence of aldehyde converts into the Fe2 plus plus HN plus benzoyl radical. Okay, na? This benzoyl radical on reaction with oxygen in the or in the presence of air converts into the perbenzoate type, perbenzoate derivative. This perbenzoate again interacts with the benzaldehyde molecule to form perbenzoic acid on perbenzoic acid and acyl free radical, phenyl free radical. ठीक है ना, ये क्या है, एसिल सी ओ फ्री रेडिकल. ठीक है ना, दीज टू एसिल और यू कैन से बेंजोइल, या अगर एलिफेटिक होता तो एसिल है, फिनाइल लगाए तो बेंजोइल. तो ना दीज टू बेंजोइल फ्री रेडिकल दे कंबाइन टुगेदर टू फॉर्म द प्रोडक्ट्स डाइमेराइड और दिस पर बेंजोइक एसिड विच इज फॉर्म फ्रॉम हियर. इट अगेन रिएक्ट्स विद द बेंजाल्डिहाइड मॉलिक्यूल टू फॉर्म द पर बेंजोइक एसिड. Then again reacts with the benzaldehyde molecule to form the two molecule of acid, simple acid, benzoic acid. Similarly, this is the anthracene molecule. Anthracene molecules on photo irradiation converts into the biradicals. They on in the presence of air combines together to form the peroxide derivative. That is the transanular peroxide. Two molecules of oxygen here is the two molecules of oxygen atom is connected in between these two rings. It is called the transanular peroxide derivative. Another example of free radical reaction is the intramolecular radical aryylation. Okay, intramolecular radical aryylation, that is also called Schorr reaction. This is called Schorr reaction, which involves thermal decomposition of the diazonium salt. You see this molecule, this is an symmetrical molecule which is diazonium functional here. In the presence of copper powder, in the presence of copper powder, this one is going to work as a catalyst. It eliminates nitrogen molecule to form the free radical, right? Now this free radical combined with this aromatic unit, this is the second phenyl unit. This free radical, it has electrons here. It is going to combine to form a cyclic ring again. So this bicyclic system become tricyclic with the delocalization of this free electron. This free electron is going to be delocalized. That eliminates for aromatization, it is going to remove this hydrogen plus proton to form copper catalyst again, copper powder. You see, this is copper here in the zero state. Then it is loss of electron. It is going to convert into the Cu plus. Cu plus again takes electron back from this free radical. It is going to be aromatized again. So it is going to be again going back to the copper zero state, copper metal state. So in that way, what will happen during the course of reaction, the copper is getting oxidized, then again getting reduced. Then overall, it goes to the formation generation of the free radical that combines with the electron of the second phenyl ring and leading to the formation of cyclization. This third ring now, because of aromatization leads to the formation of a tricyclic compound. Okay? This is now complete anthracene unit. Now it will become phenanthrene unit to form phenanthroic acid. This is the carboxylic acid, phenanthroic acid. So this is the reaction of this is example of intramolecular radical aryylation, which is commonly a known reaction known as a Schorr reaction. Schorr reaction, yaad rakhiyega, this is an important reaction, right? Now again, you see the example of the phenolic compounds. Phenol ka test bhi aap log karte hain. So homolytic aromatic reaction, homolytic aromatic reaction involving oxidation of phenol in basic solution, alkaline solution, with one electron oxidizing agent like Fe3 plus H2O2 peroxide. In that case, what will happen? When you treat phenol with the alkali solution, it first forms alkoxide. Alkoxide loses one electron to form the alkoxy radical, phenoxy radical. Now, this phenoxy radical this electron is going to delocalize in the entire system because of this resonating structure. It is going to form different resonating structure, free radical resonating structure. Now, you can see that it can couple from this ortho positions. When it is combined, going ortho-ortho coupling, so it is going to form this type of biphenyl system. Then it may also undergo two modes of this system itself. This one first combines like this one, then it leads to formation of this kind of product. Then it may also undergo for para-para coupling, that leads to the formation of the final product. So once the free radicals are formed on the phenyl rings, it may undergo for ortho-ortho coupling and then for para-para coupling, leading to the formation of different isomeric products, ortho biphenyl product, phenolic product, and this is the para-para combining, para-para connected bisphenol. So because of the different kind of connectivity, phenol shows the color during the test of the phenols. So that is the example of the free radicals. The stability I have already discussed about the free radicals. Already sab discuss kar diya tha maine. So now this is all about the free radicals, and you may read these things from any book. I will transfer these notes after completing this topic. Now, from free radicals, let us move towards another important intermediate that is called the carbene. Now, few reactions. How carbene is going to be generated? If you treat strong haloalkanes, with a strong base like lithium disisopropylamine (LDA). It is first going to form the anion, carbon ion. That carbon ion then eliminates the chloride to form this chlorocarbene. This is this two electron system. You see two electron, it shows the formation of carbene. So the carbenes are what? They are electron deficient in general. Similarly, you can treat this kind of haloalkane system with the phenyl lithium, they also first forms this anionic carbon ion species that loses the other molecule of chlorine to form this methane type. This is the another example of the carbene, which is the alkyl carbene. You can say this is the one carbon to two carbons. This is the methane, only simple. This is the halocarbene. This is the alkyl carbene. Another reaction that from where you can generate the carbene. These are also the examples of the generation of the carbenes under the conditions. From cycloelimination, reverse of the cycloaddition reactions. If you have a cyclopropene system like this one, phenyl cyclopropene, on photo irradiation or on thermolysis, it is going to form the methyl carbene. Simple methyl carbene. Similarly, this norbornadienyl ketyl. This is the ketyl system. This is the bicyclic ketyl system. This on thermolysis is also going to generate alkoxy. Alkoxy substitute. Yeah, you can say simply methoxy methyl carbene. Okay? This is the methoxy substituted carbene. This is simple methyl carbene. This one in which one R is group, this is called the alkyl carbene. When Cl is going to this, that is called the chlorocarbene. So like that, this is the methoxy substituted carbene. Similarly, you can see carbenes can also be generated with the oxidanes, epoxides. These are the example of the oxidanes or epoxide. On photolysis, it is going to give you the फेनिल कार्बीन, फेनिल देयर इज वन अल्काइल की जगह क्या है यहाँ फेनिल है, इट इज गोइंग टू जनरेट विद द मेथिल कार्बीन सब्स्टिट्यूट विद द फेनाइल बेंज, सो फेनिल मेथ कार्बीन, ठीक है. If you have simple alkyl substituents, that is going to give you the this epoxide ring. It is going to open up like that way. That is show this ring may break from here. Either it may break from this side to open up here, and then again break here to give you the alkyl carbene, or it may break from this side. Anyway, this way, this side on photolysis, it may break from this side. To eliminate the carbon function and the formation of alkyl carbene. So the epoxidase on photolysis or on thermolysis undergo decomposition reactions, or you can say a simple elimination reaction. To it is going to eliminate the carbon function, and a unit is going to form the carbenes. So these are the method. Some methods of the formation of the carbene. Similarly, carbenes can also be prepared from the diazoalkanes. Slide decline, aap logon ko. Anyone? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. From diazoalkanes, you see this is the diazo compound CH2 double bond N plus double bond N minus diazo bond, which is a resonance hybrid of four and two structure. Now this nitrogen molecule, it is a good living group. It has tendency to depart on photoiridation or on thermolysis. Then it is going to generate you a carbene. Okay, na? That carbene may be singlet carbene, and if this reaction is goes on in the gas phase, then it is going to generate a triplet carbene. So there is a difference of the orientation of the electrons in the singlet and triplet carbenes. In the singlet carbene, electrons are paired, while in the triplet carbenes, electrons are not paired and they exist in two different orbitals. Okay, na? So it can also be generated from the ketenes like R2C double bond C double bond O on photolysis. On photolysis, it is going to form the dry formation of you can say alkyl carbene, simple alkyl carbene. And you know, if you remember about the Weber-Teamer reaction, so carbenes can also be generated from the carbonyls. Like this reaction chloroform on treated with this strong in the alkaline solution, first form trichloro carbonyl, then it eliminates the molecule of chloride to form the dichlorocarbene CCl2 electron deficient dichlorocarbene. From diazerines like this kind of compound, cyclo N double bond N cyclopropyl R are substituted. On thermolysis, it is also going to give you the alkyl carbene. From the hydrazone, you can also get the carbenes like tosyl hydrazone on reaction with a carbonyl compound, first form this kind of imine system. This on treatment with a strong base eliminates the molecule of nitrogen to form this kind of long alkyl chain substituted carbene, right? Diazo, you see this kind of alpha diazo esters. They can also undergo thermolysis to form the carboalkoxy type of carbene. So, okay, CHCOOET, carboalkoxy type of carbene. So there are so many methods. There are other methods are also to form the different kinds of carbenes. So bahut sare reactions hai. These are the some examples that I have shown here. Right now, let us move towards the some typical reactions of the carbene. Carbenes generally undergo cycloaddition reactions and insertion reaction. Cycloaddition reaction and insertion reaction. An alkene undergoes cycloaddition reaction with carbenes. Now see, this is the important point. Singlet carbene add to alkene is stereospecifically. It means what? If carbene is singlet, then if alkene is cis, then it is going to form the cis product. If it is a trans, then it is going to form a trans product. In that way, the reaction is what? Stereospecific. Okay? So this is the reaction of the singlet carbenes. Singlet carbenes. However, if such kind of cycloaddition reaction takes place with triplet carbene, then this will become non-stereospecific. Means what? If your alkene is either cis or trans, and if your carbene, you see, this is the indicator of triplet carbene. जब दोनों इलेक्ट्रॉन अनपेयर्ड हो तो उसका मतलब है वो ट्रिपलेट कार्बिन है, और जब इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर्ड है तो वो क्या है, सिंगलेट कार्बिन है, ये ध्यान रखिएगा। तो दिस इज आई हैव शोन द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, इट मींस इट इज ए सिंगलेट कार्बिन, दिस वन इज ट्रिपलेट कार्बिन। सो एडिशन ऑफ ट्रिपलेट कार्बिन इज नॉन स्टीरियोस्पेसिफिक। तो वेदर इट इज सिस और ट्रांस, इफ यूर एल्कीन, अगर सिस एल्कीन रिएक्ट कर रहा है या ट्रांस एल्कीन रिएक्ट कर रहा है, तो लीड्स टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ बोथ द प्रोडक्ट्स, सिस एज वेल एज ट्रांस, बोथ द प्रोडक्ट्स आर गोइंग टू फॉर्म। व्हाइल दिस काइंड ऑफ साइक्लोएडिशन व्हेन सिस सिंगलेट कार्बिन इज गोइंग टू टेक प्लेस, इट लीड्स टू सिस एल्कीन इज गोइंग टू गिव यू सिस प्रोडक्ट, ट्रांस एल्कीन गिव यू ट्रांस प्रोडक्ट। सच टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शन प्रोडक्ट्स आर यूज्ड टू डिस्टिंग्विश, इट इज अ काइंड ऑफ रिएक्शन बाय विच यू कैन डिस्टिंग्विश singlet and triplet carbenes. The reason behind is that addition of singlet carbene is stereospecific because it takes place in concerted, because the reaction goes in the concerted manner and without spin inversion. Spin inversion singlet carbene mein reaction mein duration mein nahi ho raha, and it is a concerted reaction. Means for this electrons donation and this electron donation takes place simultaneously through an intermediate like this way. So alkene reacts with this carbene. This is a singlet carbene, right? Singlet carbene. It reacts to form an transition state of a cyclopropyl type of geometry. Then that leads to the formation of a stereospecific product. However, when this type of addition takes place with the triplet carbene, this addition takes place in two steps. First step, form a biradical which undergo spin inversion or by rotation of carbon-carbon bond. Either spin rotation of this carbene species will take place, or this CC bond is going to rotate. So either way, there is a change in the structure or stereochemistry of the alkene product. So during spin inversion, what will happen? Product is stereospecific, while CC rotation, that leads to the formation of a non-stereospecific product. So in that way, when triplet carbene addition takes place, the reaction will become non-stereospecific. You see this example, then alkene reacts upon with this triplet carbene. Right, so it is a two-step reaction, it is not a concerted reaction. So first it is going to form a biradical, this two biradical. So for cyclization of this one, there is should be either spin inversion, right? If suppose spin inversion goes, so this electron will change its direction or in that direction, then they will couple together to form this kind of product. So during the course of spin inversion, when spin inversion takes place at the center of the alkene carbene, the reaction will be some sort of stereospecific. Yahan tak ka reaction stereospecific hai, to yani ki ek product mil gaya aapko. But it is also possible beside spin inversion, there is a rotation of CC bond. Bond rotate kar jaye. For example, this RH, this R is up and this RH is down. Now here, because of bond rotation, what will happen? This R comes down and H goes up. Okay? So if rotation of CC bond takes place, or here is what, with the rotation of this one, the position of the substituent is going to change. Now see that the cyclopropane ring, which is formed ultimately, it has different geometry. So in that way, that product is supposed to be non-stereospecific product. So overall, this that I have shown stepwise to understand how this reaction becomes non-stereospecific to give you the measure of product. So alkene with triplet carbene reacts with triplet carbene for cycloaddition reactions. It this reaction is going to take place in the two step via the formation of the biradical, and biradical either may undergo spin inversion or may undergo bond rotation around CC bond that ultimately leads to the formation of a non-stereospecific, in which if suppose your alkene is going to be cis, then up to certain percentage cis product is formed along with formation of trans product. Trans product bhi banega, cis product banega. ठीक है, अगर यही एल्कीन इनिशियल एल्कीन अगर आपका ट्रांस होता है तो दैट आल्सो लीड्स टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ बोथ ट्रांस एज वेल एज सिस प्रोडक्ट्स. सो बोथ द प्रोडक्ट्स आर गोइंग टू फॉर्म मेकिंग द रिएक्शन और मेकिंग द एडिशन ऑफ एल्कीन विद ट्रिपलेट कार्बीन नॉन स्टीरियो स्पेसिफिक. द एडिशन ऑफ कार्बीन विद सम एरोमेटिक कंपाउंड्स राइट, ठीक है ना, राइट, कार्बो एल्कोक्सी कार्बीन, carboalkoxycarbene, this carboalkoxycarbene which is generated by the thermolysis of the azo carbo system, this on azo, because of this elimination of nitrogen molecule leads to the formation of carboalkoxycarbene. This carboalkoxycarbene reacts with aromatic ring to form this kind of bicyclic product. This is bicyclic product, then it is again going to open up from this, it is going to open up. So six member ring, because of addition of one carbon, there is addition of one carbon, it will become a seven member ring. This is called a cyclohexatriene system. So the addition of carbene with aromatic system leads to the formation of ring enlargement, and six member ring become seven member ring with the breaking of this this bond of the cyclopropane ring. Similarly, this phenanthrene molecule on reaction with the dichlorocarbene, it leads to the formation of dichlorocyclopropane derivative like this way, right? These are the some addition reactions of the carbene. For example, two example maine aapko diya hai, theek hai? Now come to the insertion reactions. This is the important reaction of the carbene, insertion reaction. That insertion reaction will be either intermolecular or intramolecular. Intermolecular हो सकता है या intramolecular हो सकता है. Intermolecular insertion of carbene into a CH bond may occur either in one step or in two step. That means it is a one step reaction or two step reaction in which there is the abstraction and recombination process. They takes place together. For example, if you have this kind of alkane, it reacts with a carbene like this carbene to form one is this transition state leading to the formation. What will happen? Insertion or na, one CX2 is going to be inserted, right? So it interacts with this CH bond. It interacts with the C bond. Iska alkyl group idhar hai, iska idhar hai. Now what will happen? CX bond. So it is going to connect. Now the new bond formation, this bond is going to break, this bond is going to break, right, and this bond is going to form this, that means this CH bond is going to break B and this new CC bond is going to form, that is the F, right? So it will, what will happen in between this CH bond, one carbon is going to be inserted here. So now it will become what? A one carbon, this is the one carbon alkane product. So it is now one of the suppose it is a dichlorocarbene or CX2 type of carbene or any type of carbene, it is going to be inserted between this CH bond leading to the formation of a homologous derivative, and there is addition of one more addition of carbon in the alkyl chain. So that leads to the formation of this kind of product. In that way, that carbon is going to be inserted, right? Another way, this is the concerted reaction. Yani ki it leads to the formation of a transition state in which the CH bond is going to break and new CC bond is going to form. In another way, it is going to, this is the non-concerted way of this reaction, in which what will happen? In which, in this case, this CH bond this is what? Methyl. Three methyl hai and CH bond. Okay? One of this H is CH bond is going to break, leading to the fall, and this H is going to react with the carbene that leads to the formation of this halo. This motion coming from the carbene. So this hydrogen is going to attach on this carbene, leading formation of free radical, and this alkyl substituted free radical is also going to form. Now these two free radicals then going to combine together, leading to the formation of a again homologous alkyl product. Product is both the case product is same, but it is a through the first one is through the concerted manner, and the second one through the non-concerted manner. So either it leads to the formation of an transition state like this one. This is a kind of transition state, or first it leads to the formation of a free radical intermediate. Then they are going to combine together to form the product. So this is the two way intermolecular insulation reaction proceeds. Either it may be concerted manner, or it may be non-concerted manner. Similar to cycloaddition reactions, singlet carbene undergo concerted insertion reactions without any preference. While triplet carbene, this is the fact, while the triplet carbene are inserted by a two-step process with some selectivity, and selectivity depends in the order of stability of the free radicals. Some selectivity. For example, singlet methylene is inserted to all CH bonds of 2-methylbutane. Singlet methylene is inserted to all CH bond of the, for example, 2-methylbutane. This is the example of 2-methylbutane, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. See? So this type of insertion, which I have shown here, this type of insertion is going to take place to all CH bond. It has what? This CH bond, this is the CH bond, this is the CH bond, this is the CH bond, right? So it is going to be, this singlet carbene is going to insert it on all these positions, leading to the formation of three products. Suppose this carbon pair insertion ho raha hai, toh it is going to form CH2, CH3. Yahan pe CH hai, it is going to form CH3. यहाँ पे CH2 था तो एक एडिशन हो गया तो इट विल बिकम CH2 CH3. दिस इज द थर्ड वन. ठीक है ना. सो ऑल द थ्री कार्बन्स आर लेवाइल फॉर द इंसर्शन रिएक्शन दैट लीड्स टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ न्यू प्रोडक्ट्स व्हिच हैज वन कार्बन मोर देन द पेरेंट कार्बन. ठीक है ना. इंट्रामॉलिक्यूलर इंसर्शन ऑफ कार्बिन प्रोड्यूसेस एन एल्कीन और साइक्लोप्रोपेन. इंट्रामॉलिक्यूलर, दीज आर व्हाट, ये सब क्या थे, इंटर बिटवीन द टू मॉलिक्यूल्स था. अब ये एग्जांपल क्या है, इंट्रामॉलिक्यूलर इंसर्शन. सपोज दिस इज अ मॉलिक्यूल व्हिच हैज इटसेल्फ ए कार्बीन, सो इट मे अंडरगो टू वेरिएशन, आइदर 1-2 इंसर्शन. 1-2 इंसर्शन होगा, ठीक है ना. दैट मींस व्हाट विल हैपन, दिस इज द डॉटेड वन. डॉटेड शोज एग्जांपल ऑफ 1-2 इंसर्शन. So one of the hydrogen H free radical is going to combine with this H1, and one free radical, they are going to form a double bond. So the system is going to form new double bond here, right? This double bond is going to form with the addition of this hydrogen on this carbene, right? Now another possibility is that it may undergo 1-3 insertion. This is the example of 1-2 insertion. Now 3, the example of 1-3 insertion. One, suppose this is the carbon number 1, 2, 3, right? So this hydrogen may go on that carbon, right? So iska ek free electron yahan pe bachega, yahan pe ek free electron bachega, aur yahan pe ek free electron bachega. So they may combine together to form a cyclic product. Or another way you can say that this, you have two possibility hai, either this hydrogen go here or this alkyl may go here with the movement of this free electrons at this position. So overall, what will, there is a preference, either H or L is going to move. But here, H free radical is going to move. In the case, figure, H free radical is going to move at this position. So at this terminal, it is going to form CH2, while two alkyl groups at this terminal position, right? And this R3 position is in between. So in that way, intramolecular insertion leads to the formation of what? Cyclopropane derivative. So this product is going to form, right? Now you see, this is the system. This is the biphenyl system, which has also an inbuilt carbene, right? This no carbene. This has system 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, of 5 position pe kya hai? Hydrogen. So it may undergo 1,5 insertion. This is the example of 1,5 insertion leading to the formation of a tricyclic ring, right? Another example is simple alkyl chain, 3-carbon alkyl chain. It may undergo 1,2 insertion to form an propene, or it may undergo 1,3 insertion from here to here, leads to the formation of cyclopropene. So these are the examples of the insertion reactions, right? Now the example of another, this is the name reaction, that is the Wolff-Rayleigh reaction, alpha diazoketone, abhi aap padhenge. Wolff reaction, in which the alpha diazoketone, this is the diazo unit, this is the keto unit. Alpha diazoketone, nitrogen is going to be electron good leaving group. This nitrogen is going to be good leaving group, so it is going to depart. This carbene, this acyl carbene is going to be generated within the molecule. With the movement of this electron, this alkyl group is going to move from this carbon to this carbon, from first carbon to the second carbon. That means the 1-2 shift, there is a migration of alkyl group from acyl carbon to the carbene-carbon, leading to the formation of ketene. RCH double bond C double bond O, ketene intermediate, right? That may react with the other, in this ketene carbon, this center carbon. The center carbon is supposed to be electrophilic in nature, and it will react with different kind of nucleophilic species to form the final products. Similarly, you remember the Riemann-Thiemann reaction, that is also the example of reaction with the dichlorocarbene. So chloroform reacts with KOH to form the dichlorocarbene. Dichlorocarbene reacts with the phenolic compound or aromatic compound. For example, this, this is the phenoxide, first form phenoxide. And this dichlorocarbene is what? This is electron deficient, so it will behave as an electrophile, right? And here the aromatic ring is electron rich, it is going to behave as a nucleophilic species. So this electron from the aromatic ring goes on to this dichlorocarbene, leading to the formation of this first intermediate. Then it will undergo for 1,2 insertion reaction. That means this hydrogen is going to move from this aromatic carbon to this side chain carbon, that is the dichlorocarbene carbon, to form the CHCl2 that takes proton from the medium to form the phenoxy-CHCl2 that upon hydrolysis further leads to the formation of this hydroxy-CHCl2 product, which on alkaline hydrolysis finally leads to the formation of the aldehydic product. Aldehydic, the hydroxy aldehyde, the cinnamaldehyde, like a product with the acetyl aldehyde, like that. So this is the Riemann-Thiemann reaction, which is also an example of the reaction of the phenol with the dichlorocarbene, okay, leading to formation of acetyl aldehyde product. So these are the some examples that shows the reactivity of the carbenes. Okay, now the top another point has now important point as well, that is the about the structure of the carbene. About this structure of the carbene, carbene may have two arrangement on, because you see overall total number of orbitals kitne hai in the total number of electrons kitne hai carbene mein, 6 electron hai. ठीक है ना, ओवरऑल देयर इज अ 6 इलेक्ट्रॉन. नाउ सी दिस स्ट्रक्चर, This is the carbon, center carbon. It is CH2, for example. CH2, so two orbitals here. See? And here are the two orbitals which has electrons. And there are two different arrangement of these in these two orbitals, vacant orbitals. On the basis of the arrangement of electrons in this vacant orbital, you may have different geometry. Okay. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Sound.
Hello.
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Yes, sir.
क्या है, क्या हो गया? कुछ कहना है? नहीं. ठीक है. तो टुडे आई एम यू हैव क्लास.
यस सर, प्रैक्टिकल क्लासेस फ्रॉम 10 AM ऑनवर्ड.
अभी 10 AM है ना, अभी तो 9:50 है. ठीक है, शुड आई क्लोज?
मैं आई हैव टू रीच टू लैब.
अच्छा अच्छा अच्छा, तो मैं बंद करता हूँ. ठीक है, आज का क्लास. ठीक है. हेलो हेलो. मीटिंग.
थैंक यू सर.
कुछ बच्चे हैं जो प्रैक्टिकल करने भी जा रहे हैं. ओके, ऑल ऑफ यू मे लीव द मीटिंग एंड गो इन द क्लासेस.